And greetings from Arrowinderhead Stadium in Carcass City, Missouri. Where a traffic jam of 10 cars waiting to pass a tractor on the highway. The Rockets fans have been tailgating since early this morning and are ready for some football. It's the Mayhem Bowl, and today's matchup features the two best teams in the league. The Brooklyn Invaders take on the Galaxy Chaos. Tonight's presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. We are going down to the sidelines now to listen in on the pregame speech. Kickoff to the biggest game of the year, the NFL Mayhem Bowl, is just moments away. Hi, everyone. Grim Blitzrow here, along with color commentator Brickhead Mulligan and the mini Pez dispenser on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
Grim, I can't wait for the Mayhem Bowl start. I got a lot of money riding on it.
Pez dispenser, huh? Yeah, better than having that crap dispenser pie hole you got for a mouth.
And moving on. And it's first and 10.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And it's first and 10. 4 yards on that one, and he was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and 6.
You can't keep us down.
I've seen this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again.
You know, good communication is important.
First and 10. And a nice pass for a 10-yard gain.
It's not a first down in the stat line, but it's a first down in our hearts.
Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. No one was interested in that incomplete pass.
Not a ball's feelings are hurt.
Hey, don't make me explain that balls don't have emotions again, all right? And that'll bring up third down and inches. And he catches it for a touchdown! What a beautiful play!
Yeah, and Dodo's power on the grin like a haiku!
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim!
Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And it's first and 10. About 3 on that play. Second down and 7. First down! He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. And it's first and 10. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? It's anyone's game at the end of quarter one. Second down and two. Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. Third and two. Looks like they're just going to pound it up the middle all night, Bricks.
They call that the honeymoon offense.
I'm not going to touch that one.
That's what she said.
And it's first and ten. Man, what a hit that was. And it's first and ten. Retired, Bricks.
Well, he's retired permanently now. At least he'll save some money on the retirement party.
Good point. First down in a mile.
Not one, not two.
And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. The offense calls their first time out. Second down and a very long.
Not one, not two.
He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Well, that's a real buzzkill. He was starting to go somewhere, but he gets stomped after three.
They usually stop me after three, too. You know, the all-you-can-eat buffets? They're not as literal as you think.
Chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
And it's first and ten. And the defense jumps offside, trying to mute it. This guy can talk before he died. What do you think he'd be saying, Bricks?
Psycho killer! Just to say, what the
first down and one. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Actually, he does have some turkeys getting wrapped on his backside from that bad burn he had last year.
Don't make any mistakes here. or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field. Controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. And it's first and ten. And the quarterback, you know, you gotta put the buzzsaw in the MVP conversation, Briggs. Got more kills than anyone in the league right now.
Yeah, you make a good point.
Take their last time out.
It's between them and the clock now, Grim.
Well, and the defense, too.
I want Sean Kidd to make a kick like this with his extra leg. He used it like a golf club.
That wasn't a leg, you moron. That was Tripod Jenkins. Along with the...
He is automatic. Nice kick.
Boring. Just give him the points and let's move on.
Looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck off. That was just a one-time thing.
Oh, and he just left an outline on the ground like he was trying to wipe off the dinosaur. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. Start. Neither team really pulling away.
What's about who wants it more, Grim? And who's gonna run into a saw blade by accident? And who's gonna be the unlucky bastard that steps on a mine? And who?
Yeah, we get the idea. And why don't you be the unlucky bastard that falls down the stairs on your way to get your hot dog?
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
He just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Second down and 10.
First and 10.
That, my friend, 3-point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuff burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Is trying to keep some time on the clock for their offense, or someone let a real bonehead touch the controller. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, and he just turns ginormous. Look out! He just picked the receiver's pocket, and the defense gets a turnover. He punched his way out of that tackle. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And the defense goes for the jugular and run. And in some leagues, you aren't even allowed to touch the QB. In the NFL, they have plays just for killing them. That's what I'm talking about. And it's first and ten. Controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock-blocked the clock.
The quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. And the ball hits The quarterback burns his last time out. He can't stop the clock anymore. Well, it's crunch time. For the defense's sake, they had better take that literally.
Come on, you assholes. I need to...
Oh, man, I love this dirty trick. The quarterback unleashes a rocket. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Briggs. And like your Aunt Bertha, this guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry up. The Galaxy Chaos have lost the game.
And I'm out $50.
The Mayhem Bowl comes to an end in a classic battle. It's a 3-point win, and Mubble will go down as one of the all-time great Mayhem Bowls.
Man, it wasn't as good as the 49 game when Sloppy Ham called the hook and splatter play and decapitated the entire defensive line, along with the cheerleaders in the overtime win, but that was pretty good.
The Mayhem Bowl MVP is about to speak. Once again, the folks at EvilSN thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation of the Mayhem Bowl. Until next season, this is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Are we off now?
All right, whose turn is it to buy the rounds?
It's Junior's. I bought last year.
Hey, screw you. Everyone knows it's your turn. You're a lying pansy.
I could have sworn I paid last time.
Today's game...